Hello and welcome to the sixth episode of the C++ series. In this episode, we're going to talk about scope and namespaces. In any language, scope, the context, what is the background, has a high impact on a given action or statement validity. The same is true in a programming language. In a program, what we have various constructs, maybe objects, variables, or any other such. They come into existence from the point where we declare them, before as you can declare them as unknown, and then at some point they are destroyed. As we will see that there are many reasons to be so, and all are destroyed when your program terminates. We will see that variables have a finite lifetime when your program executes, that the scope of an object or variable is simply the part of a program in which the variable name exists or is visible to the compiler. We have two scopes, the global and local scope. The default scope is defined as the global scope. This is commonly used to define and use global variables or global structs, like classes, structures, functions, and so on. This makes them valid and visible to the compiler at all times. The local scope relates to the scope created inside a compound statement. The compound statement was explained in a previous episode. But for now, just imagine the local scope between curly braces. There are also namespaces. The namespace keyword allows you to create a new type of scope. The name is optional and can be omitted to create an unnamed namespace. Once you create a namespace, you have to refer to it explicitly or use the using word. A namespace is defined with the namespace block. As you can see in this file, I'm making a namespace called tutorial. Inside this, you can declare an object or an int. Then you can use this by using the namespace. With the namespace declared, we can use identifiers to use the namespace outside the declared namespace. Outside of this block, the namespace specifier must be used as a prefix. For example, outside the namespace tutorial, the integer must be written down as tutorial double point double point integer name. C++ includes other constructs that makes this verbosity unnecessary. By adding the line using namespace tutorial to a piece of code, the prefix is no longer needed. So as you can see in the code, we're typing using namespace tutorial, and then the integer is available directly. This using directive indicates that any name used but not declared within the program should be sought in the standard namespace. To make a single name from a namespace available, the following using declaration can exist. Using and then tutorial, double point, and then the name of your variable. After this declaration, the name of the variable can be used inside the current namespace instead of the more verbose version, tutorial, double point, variable name. Note that the programmers often use these term declaration and directive interchangeable, despite their technically different meanings. It's good practice to use the narrow second form using the using declaration, because the broad first form using directive might make more names available than desired. For example, namespace tutorial has two variables, int bar double pi, and then in the second one we're using the namespace of tutorial. But inside this we make a variable called int pointer pi. Now we have a big T between the pi here and in the namespace foo, of in the namespace tutorial. So please look out that you don't use the same names inside different namespaces. With this, the episode comes to an end. Please like and subscribe to support this C++ series. Thanks for watching, until next time. Bye.